So in previous video we had discussed about SJRF, which is shortest job first scheduling. So in this video we will discuss about priority scheduling. So what basically priority scheduling is, that we will allocate the resources to the process which are having the greatest priority. Okay, so which one is having the greatest priority, we will allocate the resource to that process only. So as you can see that here there is an extra column with respect to process and burst time. There we are having priority as an extra column. And don't take the misconception of having the greatest number as greatest priority. Here we are getting the one as greatest priority, like rank in our class. Okay, so the one is having the greatest priority and the five being the least. Okay, so let's start the execution. So here we can see that at t equal to 0, let's say all the process are arriving at t equal to 0. Okay, so there should be no confusion between the arrival time. After that, it will check which process is having the greatest priority. So here we can see that process 2 is having the greatest priority. So this process will be allocated. Okay, so process 2 will be allocated. After that, process 2 will be over and it is given by the 1 second burst time. Okay, so 1 second burst time is being awarded to the process 2. After that, the process 5 is having the greatest priority, which is having priority as 2. Okay, so it will be awarded by the resources it needs, and the process 5 will get over, means it will complete its execution. And at t equal to 6, which process is having the greatest priority? Yes, process 1 is having the greatest priority, which is 3. After 1, 2, it will come to 3 and will execute the whole burst. Okay, after the process 1 will be over, it will check for the next priority, which is priority process 3, which is having priority of 4. Okay, so process 3 will be executed, and in the same way after that process 4 will be over. So we are having a disadvantage. Guess what is the disadvantage of this type of scheduling? Yes, if one process which is having greatest burst time is having the priority as coming earlier with majority of the process, what I am saying is that if the one process which is having the greatest burst time is having the greatest priority, then all the other process of the table have to wait for a long time, which means it will result in long waiting time. So it should not be happening. Okay, so the average waiting time we can calculate here, we'll get 8.2 milliseconds. So we have to keep this disadvantage away from our scheduling process. So for that part, we are implementing round robin scheduling. So what round robin scheduling is, that it will, means irrespective of priority, it will give the handle of one process from one process to another process after one quantum. So what is the quantum is that a smallest unit of time called a time quantum or time slice is defined here. So let's say we are giving quantum of 4 milliseconds. Okay, so after 4 milliseconds, system will automatically switch the context and will give the handle from one process to other process. What I'm saying is that, let's say the there are three process. One is having 24 burst time, the others are having 3 milliseconds. Okay, so after 0 to 4 means 4 quantum seconds, automatically the handle will be shifted to the other process, means P1 to P2. So the automatically context switch will happen, or you can say that preemption will happen, and the handle or execution will be given to the process 2. Now the process 2 is having only 3 milliseconds, but we are having the quantum of 4 milliseconds, but it will not wait for that 1 millisecond, and it will start soon after the process 2 will be over, means after 3 milliseconds the process 3 will be start executing. Now as we can see, the process 3 is also having the quantum, means the burst time of just 3 seconds, but we are having the quantum of 4 milliseconds, but it will not wait again for 1 extra millisecond, and it will give the handle to the next process, which is process 1 here. Okay, now the process 1 is having the remaining of 20 milliseconds, and we are having just one process. So also by giving means giving the preemption to other process, but we are having just one process, means after 4 milliseconds, means one quantum, it will again shift the execution to the next process, but there is only one process, so it will execute just one process, which is P1. Okay, so after 4 milliseconds, it will again preempt, but it will see that there is only one process which is there, so it will again process or executes the process 1. Again it will see that whether we have to give the handle to any other process, but it will see there is only one process which is P1. It will again give the system handle to process 1. In same way, it will give at 22 milliseconds, and again at 26 milliseconds. At the end of 30 milliseconds, the process P1 will get over, and all the process are completed in this fashion. Now just have one observation, is that after at the end of all the process, we are getting this 30 milliseconds, and just sum up these burst time, 24 milliseconds plus 3 27 and plus 3 30. Okay, so at the end of all the process, we must get all the burst time sum, and like 24 plus 3 plus 3 is 30. So we should get this burst time as the completion time of all the process. The average waiting time is 5.66 milliseconds. So in modern systems, this round robin scheduling is implemented. Okay, but here also we are getting some disadvantages, which we are not discussing here for now, but there are disadvantages of round robin scheduling. So in next video, we will discuss about thread scheduling. So till then, thank you.